I want to thank you all so much for coming out this afternoon. I'm extremely grateful to all of you and to the board of the Northwest Symphony Orchestra and all these fantastic people behind me. I have extreme gratitude to all of you for being selfless enough and courageous enough and compassionate enough to allow us to have this opportunity to put on a concert. And I appreciate the fact that you are all willing to get vaccinated and wear a mask and look beyond yourselves and allow us that opportunity. And I'm grateful for all these people behind us. And I'm grateful for the support of the board who have implemented those safety guidelines for us to help keep us well throughout this pandemic. Their leadership has been just fantastic. So I say kudos to them. We're going to end tonight's, or this afternoon's concert with the third symphony of Robert Schumann, the Rhenish symphony. It's a very joyful symphony. I think at the beginning it's impossible not to hear Beethoven Eroica in it. It's the same key, the same sort of feel to it. Very joyous, very buoyant. The second movement is not as scherzo as we might expect, but a Ländler, more of a minuet tempo, so slower. And then a beautiful third movement, just gorgeous song-like lead, if you will. And then this fantastic fourth movement that I think makes the piece. I was inspired by a trip that Robert and his wife Clara made to Cologne, and upon seeing the huge cathedral there. So you'll hear this kind of religious overtones, like with old style religious music, if you will, counterpoint and long held out chordal harmonies. And then a very joyous last movement, very lively, very happy, very much against what was coming next for Schumann, which was a very happy, unhappy time, and for himself, and I think within maybe 4 or 5 years, he was dead. But this piece just is imbued with joy and spirit, and so I hope you enjoy Schumann, Third Symphony, Rhenish. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.